Have you ever wanted to make a script to change your scene? Maybe align some nodes, or maybe find and change several nodes at once. There is a very unknown feature that can help you with that. You can use Godot's Editor Script class to quickly run any code from the editor. Let's create one now and see some examples. Create a script named MyScript and make sure it inherits from Editor Script. The way this works is very simple. You can use the getScene function to get your current scene root node, and use file run to execute the code inside the run function. You can also use the editor interface class to interact with the editor. Using the getSelection.getSelectedNodes will give you a list of your selected nodes. We can select a few nodes and run the script again to see how it changes. Knowing that, we can make some useful quick scripts. Here's a simple one that takes all of the children of the selected node and puts them into a circle. Make sure our parent node is selected and hit run. And back to our scene, the nodes are in a circle. But that's hard to see, so here's one way we can improve that. Inside the script screen, press this icon to turn it into a floating window. Let's make it smaller, and now we can kinda see what's happening. So let's change the radius and hit run again. But be careful, code executed here can't be undone as they don't generate the undo action, so Ctrl-Z won't work. Make sure to save a backup of your scene if you are unsure. You can use the editor script as a quick way to store useful actions, and turn them on and off as needed. Here's a script that randomly offsets all of the children nodes. And here's another to align the selected node to an axis. Here, I'm using the last selected node's axis to align it to. This way, I can quickly select all the nodes I want, and just unselect and select again the object that I wanted to align to. You can also hold Ctrl to reselect the nodes from the scene tree. We can also use editor scripts as a quick way to align our nodes. I can pass an axis and an offset, and it will distribute the nodes along a grid. And here are some considerations. When instancing nodes, you also need to set the owner of that node to the scene root. You can do that by setting node.owner equals getScene. If you don't do that, it won't show up in the scene tree or persist when saving. And when iterating over nodes, you need to make sure they are properly instanced. That is, they are not our linked node children. Look at what happens when we go over all the nodes and set their visibility to false. If we don't check for the owner, we are going to change even the children of linked scenes, and that will give us some strange behavior. And that's it! A quick way to make changes to your scenes. Editor scripts can be useful as an easy way to automate changes and move things around. I hope you liked this video. And until next time.